Now we're going to say that Ka represents our acid dissociation constant. And it basically measures how strong our weak acids are. And we're going to say weak acids use Ka, weak bases don't use Ka. Instead, they use Kb. So this is our base dissociation constant. And what we're going to say here is their relationship to each other, Ka and Kb, can be expressed by this formula. Kw equals Ka times Kb. And as you realize, this Kw is the same Kw we saw earlier. In the earlier times, we saw it as Kw equals H positive times OH minus. It's the same exact Kw. And we're going to say in general, the higher the Ka value, then the stronger the acid. The stronger the acid, the greater the concentration of H plus. Now we're going to say related to Ka is pKa. And remember, we've talked about what P means. P means negative log. So pKa means negative log of Ka. Here we're going to say there's an inverse relationship. It's actually the lower the pKa, the stronger the acid, and the stronger the acid, the greater the H plus concentration. Now what we're going to say here is when it comes to a weak acid, we're going to say weak acid tends to have Ka value less than 1 and a pKa value greater than 1. Just realize we said inverse relationship. So Ka and pKa are opposites. If one is up, the other one is down. Strong acids tend to have pKa's much greater than 1. Ka's much greater than 1. And they tend to have pKa's lower than 1. pKa's that are negative. And remember, we should be able to establish a relationship between Ka and pKa in the same way we've been able to establish a relationship between H positive and pH. Because here, we can just simply say Ka equals 10 to the negative pKa. And we could also say the same thing for pKb. pKb equals negative log of Kb, and therefore Kb equals 10 to the negative pKa. Just remember these relationships and how they affect the acidity of our compound. As long as you can remember these few quick, easy calculations, you'll be able to go from one to the other. And one last thing. We can say here that the relationship from pKa and pKb can be established by looking at this equation here. By taking the negative log of Kw, Ka, and Kb, we say that the equation becomes 14 equals pKa plus pKb. Now that we've seen all these types of new variables and new types of equations, attempt to do the practice question on the bottom. Here I say if the Kb of NH3 is 1.76 times 10 to the negative 5, what is the acid dissociation constant of the conjugate acid? Conjugate acid is a term we learned earlier a few videos back, but here we're given Kb. We're asked to find the acid dissociation constant. So it's a simple conversion from one unit to another. So once you're done with that, click back on the explanation button and see how I approach this problem. Good luck, guys.